So welcome to the class. Now, so do you know what bureaucracy is? What is the definition of bureaucracy? Can anyone quote it out? Or if you possible, I want everyone to tell me in simple language what bureaucracy is. What is bureaucracy? Bureaucrats, bureaucracy, we often hear these terms, right? So what is meant by this term bureaucracy? See, bureaucracy, when it comes to bureaucracy, it's the way of, you know, administration, like organizing large number of people who need to work together. You need to organize the groups, right? Is it clear? So organizing, you know, large number of people together, right? Okay, so bureaucracy basic. Is it clear what bureaucracy means? In the past, organizations were commonly structured as bureaucracies. Okay, a bureaucracy is a form of organization based on logic, order, and the legitimate use of formal authority. Bureaucracies are meant to be orderly, fair, and highly efficient. Their features include a clear-cut division of labor, strict hierarchy of authority, formal rules and procedures, and promotion based on competency. Okay. Today, many people view bureaucracies negatively. Yeah, good evening, Vasi. And recognize that bureaucracy have their limits. Okay, if organizations rely too much on rules and procedures, they become unwieldy and too rigid, right? So see, following a rule is good, okay? But if you are becoming rigid with it, you know, nowadays people see bureaucracy as something in negative form because, you know, it makes you rigid. Nowadays, you know, there's too much competition, so you just cannot get rigid with anything. You have to be very flexible, right? Making them slow to respond to changing environment. So see, if you are following bureaucracy upmost, in upmost sense, in that case, what is going to happen? It will make you too rigid, and if you are too rigid, you won't be able to adapt to the changing environment, and environment is changing like anything. Every day, you are going to see a new company in the market. So in this, you know, competition is very, very high. Okay, and more likely to perish in the long run. And if you are, you know, like very rigid about things, you don't want to accept change, whether it's an employee or an organization, then in that case, they are going to perish in the long run, right? Correct, everyone? Sanobar, Seher, Kelvin, Khadija, Rajiv, Prabha, Maria, and others. Okay. But management theory does not view all bureaucratic structures as inevitably flawed. Okay, inevitably flawed. So see, they just say that they find a bit of negativity in bureaucracy. But it's not like all the bureaucratic structures are flawed. It's not like you're going to find flaws in all bureaucratic structures. It's not this. Everything has its pros and cons, negativity and positivity. Okay, so I'm talking in that sense. Instead, they ask these critical questions. When is a bureaucracy a good choice for an organization? So, you see, you should switch off and on. Okay? It's not like you take something into a, you know, like a prominent, you'll just focus on one thing. You'll just go the way you are going. You should switch on and off as per the required needs. As per the required needs of the customers, environment, changing environment, and your competitors, you know. Now, what alternatives exist when a bureaucracy is not a good choice? Suppose the bureaucracy is not a good choice. Okay, so you have to switch off. So what you should choose then? Okay, research conducted in England. Bureaucracies, like this thing, our constitution and all, policy making group and all, like government. Like, you know, like these HRD ministry and all. Okay. Okay, fine, Rajiv. Is it fine now? Okay. Research conducted in England by Tom Burns and George Stocker in the early 1960s attempted to answer these questions. Burns and Stocker study industrial firms to determine how the nature of each firm's environment affected the way the firm was organized and managed. They believed a stable, unchanging environment demanded a different type of organization than a rapidly changing one. Okay? Although a stable environment worked well under a bureaucracy, a managers in a constantly changing, innovative environment needed an organizational structure that allowed them to be responsive and creative. So see, if you know you are following utmost bureaucracy, in that case you cannot put to use your own creativity, which will you know, like, which is going to yield better results, right? As a result, two distinct frameworks, the mechanistic and organic structures, were identified. The mechanistic structure, sometimes used synonymously, the bureaucratic structure, is a management system based on a formal framework of authority that is carefully outlined and precisely followed. An organization that uses a mechanistic structure is likely to have following characteristics. Clearly specified tasks, okay, like defense ministry and all, right? Precise definitions of rights and obligations of members. Army headquarters, that is an example of bureaucratic setup, right? Clearly defined line and staff positions with formal relationships between the two. Fine, everyone? Perhaps the best example of a mechanistic structure is found in college or university. Consider the very rigid and formal college entrance and registration procedures. The reason for such procedure is to ensure that organization is able to deal with a large number of people in an equitable and fair manner. Is it clear what a bureaucratic setup is? Racy, you are not able to see the board. How about others? Are you able to see the board properly? So do one thing, Racy. Why don't you rejoin the class again? Will you mind rejoining the class again? Just rejoin the class again. Okay, now. Although many individuals do not like them, regulations and standard, okay, yeah. Maria, you also rejoined the class again. Prabhavati, Seher, Sanobar, Kelvin, are you able to see the board properly? Yeah, very good evening, Sheikh. All right. Good. Thanks for asking. Okay. Now, consider the very rigid and formal, this we have read. So, is it clear what bureaucratic structure is, where, you know, they are very strict about rules and they are not going to change it. And they do it because, you know, they want to deal with large number of, because, you know, for a college entrance, they get lakhs and lakhs of, you know, like applications. So, they want to deal with it, you know, in a fair manner. Otherwise, you know, people are going to put allegations on them. So, that's why they do it in that manner. They follow a strict bureaucratic structure. Although many individuals do not like them, regulation and standard operating procedure pretty much guarantee uniform treatment. But those same rules and procedures, with their time-consuming communication and decision-making processes, tend to bog down organizations. So see, you might have seen in case of government examinations like TET, PGDT and all those B.Ed examinations, it consumes a lot of time. It is a bureaucratic function, okay, but you cannot rule out the possibility of you know, like unfair treatment in that, right? Sometimes, you know, people, things get leaked out. So you just cannot say that if you are doing it, and this, you know, bureaucratic structure is very, very time consuming, right? You might have seen people who give IAS exams in India. Sometimes, you know, they don't get results even after 4 years of giving examination, right? You might have seen that, right, everyone? So it's a very time consuming process, and nowadays there is so much competition that they need you know, earlier results. They need immediate results, right, everyone? Okay. Fine, great. Any questions for me? Or shall we proceed ahead? Any questions, anyone out there? Any questions, anyone? No. How about others? Maria, Sheikh, Racy? All right. Now, Maria, you cannot see? Still you cannot see? But others are able to see it. Maria, just check your system. Just check if there is some issue with your system, because others are able to see it well, I guess. Okay. So just check what is the issue at your end and try to rectify it. Okay. Now, mechanistic organizations are appropriate when the economic external environment is fairly stable. Yes, sure. Khadija is trying to help you. Please see what he has written in the chat box. The biggest drawback to the mechanistic structure is lack of flexibility. So, you know, mechanistic structure, they are not flexible. Okay? Which may cause an organization to have trouble adjusting to change and coping up with the unexpected. Fine. So, did you understand what are the cons? You know, like the negativity of, you know, this mechanistic setup, bureaucratic setup. It doesn't accept change, okay, and it finds it very difficult to cope up with the unexpected. Fine? Fine, everyone? Okay, fine. Okay. Now, I would request you to see this video. Okay, I'm just sharing one link in the chat box. Kindly try to, you know, open it and see it, and then we're going to proceed ahead. Yeah, please do the same. The link is there in the chat box. Try to open it and see it. Are you able to open the video? It's okay, Kelvin. We are dealing with bureaucracy basics. What bureaucracy is, I have given them one video link. So you have to click on this and you have to see the video. Rajiv, Maria, Racy, Sheikh, Fahad, Prabhavati, Khadija, Sanobar and Seher. Are you watching that video? It's okay. Maria, don't be sorry. It's okay. Okay? Just wait for a while. You can save the link and you can watch it later. या यस केल्विन, यू आर सेइंग समथिंग, यू आर सेइंग समथिंग, व्हाट इज द इश्यू केल्विन? यस केल्विन, आर यू एबल टू वॉच दैट वीडियो? एंड वंस यू आर डन जस्ट लेट मी नो प्लीज. आई नो फॉर दैट यू हैव टू साइन इन. ओके so you can watch the complete video at home itself, fine. This is just to give you the idea of what bureaucracy is, a bit idea of what bureaucracy is. Okay, yes, okay. I hope whatever you have seen. Yeah. What? Kelvin, what you have written? Kelvin, what you have written, I am not able to get you. I just want to know if I am no, what is that? Okay. Just let me know, this Kelvin, what you are writing, I am not getting you. Maria, are you able to see the board properly now? Okay, let's proceed ahead. The organic structure tends to work better in a dynamic environment where managers need to react quickly to change. Okay, nowadays they need managers. I don't know what is the issue. You can just listen to me, Maria. Okay, I don't know what is the issue that you are in. Okay, so you can just listen to me. All right, now and then you can later on you can see the recording. Now, see, the organic structure is like it's needed at places where managers need to Fahad is saying something, Maria. Where managers need to react quickly to change. Okay? An organic structure is a management system founded on cooperation and knowledge-based authority. It is much less formal than mechanistic organization. Okay? And much so this organic system is much more flexible, and this is for organizations or managers who need to react quickly to change. Okay? Now, organic structures are characterized by roles that are not highly defined. Okay? Okay. MNCs, right? Tasks that are continually redefined. It's not like they'll hire you for something, but you have to be flexible with other things too. You have to switch over. You need to have that capability. Right, everyone? Nowadays, they look for someone who is versatile. Little reliance on formal authority, decentralized control, fast decision-making, informal patterns of both delegation and communication. Because the atmosphere is informal and the lines of authority may shift. Depending on the situation, the organic structure requires more cooperation among employees than bureaucracy. Because the laws and rules are not that strict as in case of mechanistic organizations. Fine? Is it clear so far? Shall we proceed ahead? One example of an organic structure is Salvation Army. Although branches are located throughout the nation, the organization does not have a complex structure. It encourages different units to take on new challenges. The Salvation Army do not rely heavily on written rules and procedure. Okay, therefore, this organization can create the procedure that works best at different situations arise. The Salvation Army's ability to take on new tasks and fulfill its mission regardless of the circumstances it faces is one of the reasons why it is the hallmark of organic organizations. Do you know what is the hallmark of organic organization? I'll show it to you. Hallmark for I should wait for a while. I'll show it to you. Wait. Yeah, Salvation Army logo. I'll show it to you. Something of this kind. Yeah, this is the one. I'm just sharing it with you in the chat box itself. Yeah. Please see it. Clear? Fine. All right. Yeah, it's a logo. Correct. Is all about bureaucracy basics. Now, what is the difference between a mechanistic structure and organizational structure? Not, sorry. Organic structure. You have to write it down. And what are the qualities of mechanistic organizations and what are the qualities of this organic structures? You have to write that down as well. Okay. And which one you feel is better? Okay. The first one, it's up to you. It's your personal, like viewpoint. Okay. Whether it's mechanistic one or organic one, whichever one. Okay. Is it clear what you have to do? So just start writing it down. Yeah, everyone needs to write it down. Kelvin, are you able to follow me? Kelvin. What? No, not at all. Okay, fine. So you are able to follow me, right? Right, Kelvin? Kelvin, are you able to follow me? Yes or no? You are not able to follow me? Why? What you are not able to follow? Let me know in the chat box. Wait, I'm going to unmute you. Okay, Kelvin, you are being unmuted. Please accept the audio control. Or you can do one thing, Kelvin. You can post your queries in the chat box. Whatever. See, today we are doing about bureaucratic structures. As of now, we have dealt with mechanistic organizations and organic organizations too. So, what kind of ideologies they follow and what are the characteristics of those kinds of organizations, this is what we have learned. I guess you have joined late. That is the reason why you are not able to follow, I guess. Right? Hi, Lakshmi. How are you? Good to see you after so long. Okay. Okay. Kelvin, you can do one thing. You can see the recording. Okay. Okay. I can understand. You can see the recording. Okay. And Rajiv, Prabhavati, Fatima, Racy, Sheikh, Fahad, Khadija, Sanobar, and Seher. Are you writing it down? The difference between like this two structures, that is organic structure and mechanistic. Okay. So just wait for a while. So actually, we are learning about bureaucratic structures today, Lakshmi. Okay. So I have just told them about the basics of that. Okay, bureaucratic basics. And now factors affecting organizational design. Bureaucratic structures are, tougher, right? They are tougher. They follow more rules. They are less flexible, but it is not required these days. Nowadays, there is a trend for organic structure where, people are flexible. They don't have a particular job. They have to be, they have to do multitasking. Okay. It is written here. Okay. They need to take fast decisions and informal patterns of communication are being followed. Fine. And after this, we are going to learn about factors affecting organizational design. So let others finish it and then we are going to switch over to the new topic. Okay. Fine. And now you can write about mechanistic organization. Rajiv. Okay, fine. Take 5 minutes and then after that. We are going to switch over the next thing. Okay, fine, Prabhavati. ओके ग्रेट खदीजा, शैल वी प्रोसीड अहेड एवरीवन आउट देयर? Shall we proceed ahead? Okay, thank you. So now let us learn about the organizational design. Fine writing. Factors affecting organizational design. Although many things can affect the choice of an appropriate structure for an organization, fine Prabhupati. The following five factors are most common: size, life cycle, strategy, environment, and technology. Now, organizational size. The larger an organization becomes, the more complicated its structure is. Right, when an organization is small, such as single retail store, a two person consulting firm, or a restaurant, its structure can be simple. So as you know, it grows, okay, the structure becomes complicated, right, everyone? Yeah. Now, in reality, if the organization is very, very small, it may not even have a formal structure. Instead of the for see, as they get money, as they start doing business, you know, they become you know, the setup becomes more prominent, right? Instead of following an organizational chart or specified job function, individuals simply perform tasks based on their likes, dislikes, ability, or need. Rules and guidelines are not prevalent and may exist only to provide the parameters within which organization members can make decisions. Small organizations are very often organic systems, right? Okay. Now, any questions for me? Okay. All right, fine. As an organization grows, however, it becomes increasingly difficult to manage without more formal work assignments and some delegations of authority, right? Therefore, large organizations develop formal structures, like you have to punch the card and all those stuff, right? Tasks are highly specialized and detailed rules and guidelines dictate work procedures. Before you join them, they make you sign a contract also, right? Right. Yeah. Therefore, large organizations develop structures. Tasks are okay. This we have done. Inter-organizational communication flows primarily from superior to subordinate, and hierarchical relationships serve as the foundation for authority, responsibility, and control. The type of structure that develops will be one that provides the organization with the ability to operate effectively. So, see, in case of large organizations, it becomes, you know, it's like very important to follow this thing, right? This norm, right? That is to follow which kind of trend? To follow the trend of being bureaucratic. They have to be bureaucratic, right? Okay, fine. Now, all right. That's one reason larger organizations are often mechanistic. Mechanistic systems are usually designed to maximize specialization and improve efficiency. See, because since there are large number of people in, you know, there, So they have to manage themselves effectively. If they cannot manage them effectively, they cannot keep a control on them if they are not following this trend, right? That is being mechanistic. Fine, clear? Now, organizations' life cycle. Organizations like humans tend to progress through stages known as life cycle, right? Like humans, most organizations go through the structures like there is birth, youth, midlife, and maturity. Each stage has characteristics that has implications for the structure of the firm. Birth. In the birth state, a firm is just beginning, right? Can you name a startup company? Can you give me an example of a startup company? Just name a startup company, please. Okay. All right, all right. But that is a view. See, Prabha, we have to do this because you know the classes for this, the topic for the class is this. So how can we change it? Okay, now. In a young organization, there is not much delegation of authority. The founder usually calls the shots. Fine? Is it clear, everyone? Youth. In this phase, the organization is trying to grow. The emphasis in this stage is on becoming larger. The company shifts its attention from the wishes of the founder to the wishes of the customer. Right? The organizations become more organic in structure during this phase. It is during this phase that the formal structure is designed and some delegation of authority occurs. Is it clear what happens during a birth phase and youth phase of an organization? Clear, everyone? I hope you are not finding it boring other than Prabha. Are others also finding it boring? I know this is boring, but what to do? We have to cover that, right? Some topics are boring, okay? But we have to do it. I'm really sorry, Prabha. I cannot change it because, you know, we have to cover this too. Yeah. So see, some topics are good, some topics are bad, okay, as per our personal perception. But everything has to be covered, okay? Fine. Midlife. This phase occurs when the organization has achieved a high level of success. An organization in midlife is larger with a more complex and increasingly formal structure, okay? More level appears in the chain of command. And the founder may have difficulty remaining in control. As the organization becomes older, it becomes more mechanistic in structure. Maturity. Once a firm has reached the maturity phase, it tends to become less innovative. Okay? Less interested in expanding and more interested in maintaining itself in a stable, secure environment. Okay? The emphasis is on improving efficiency and profitability. However, in an attempt to improve efficiency and profitability, the firm often tends to become less innovative. Stale products result in sales decline and reduces profitability. Organizations in this stage are slowly dying. However, maturity is not an inevitable stage. Firms experiencing the decline of maturity may institute the changes necessary to revitalize. Right? So, you know, earlier Fair and Lovely just used to sell, you know, I always give the example of beauty products because I am a woman. So, please don't mind it. You know, my mind gets stuck in that direction. Okay? I'm sorry. Okay. So, see, Fair and I don't apply that also. Okay? I don't apply it. Whenever I think of any cream, you know, that, you know, hits my mind. Fair and Lovely. Okay? Okay. But I don't use it. Okay? I know it's not that good. So what but many people use it, okay? They want to change their skin color, but I don't think it can be changed. So there's no point applying that. Okay. So see, what happens is this Fair and Lovely, they used to sell, you know, like a particular cream. Nowadays, there is a trend, you know, people just, yeah, I know it's fake. I don't apply that. I don't use market-based products. I never use any cream. My skin is very sensitive, so I don't use any kind of product. Anyway, so I just use, you know, what the doctor has suggested me. dermatologist. I use products which they sell. Okay, so like retinoin products I use. Okay, so what happens is this. Nowadays people need a cream which can have several qualities, which can keep their skin soft and supple, which can make it fairer. So now they have revitalized themselves. Earlier they were their graphs, tail graphs were going down. Okay, so now they have a complete, they have made certain changes with that cream on the basis of ads, as I can say. And they have also came up with some kind of face wash, I guess, right? And you remember Nivea people have launched one product, so it can act as a face wash. You can use it as a mask, and you can also use it as something else, scrub. Okay, so nowadays people want that is a 3-in-1 product. Yeah, that's not very good. I used it, okay, once long time back, but it was not good, so I have thrown that thing. It was not worth. Okay, so nowadays people, so this is how they revitalize themselves. I'm just giving you one example because I'm a female, so I'm using the beauty products example. Okay, although an organization may, and every time they are coming up with new products. Although an organization may proceed sequentially through all 4 stages, it does not have to. An organization may skip a phase, or it may cycle back to an earlier phase, right? An organization may even try to change its position in the life cycle by changing its structure. As the life cycle concept implies, a relationship exists between organization. Yeah, Olay Total Effect. I haven't used that. I don't know. I guess that is anti-aging. And between an organization's size and age. Oh, Fahad has also. So he is the first male who is commenting on this. Others might not be liking it. Kelvin is not saying anything. Rajiv is not saying anything. Khadija is also not saying anything. They must be using fair and handsome, so that's why. They must be using fair and handsome. That is the male cream I have heard of. I don't know. Okay, that's why I don't use market-based products. I started getting allergy, so I never use that. Okay. It's better not to use anything. Just keep it as it is, and rather than using market-based products, you should not use, and one should not change products often. That results in allergies. Okay. Just stick to one and don't change products often. That's it. And don't overuse it. That's it. As a result, the older and larger organization becomes, the greater the likelihood that it will move from an organic structure to a mechanistic structure. Now, so is it clear? As they grow old, okay, as life cycle continues, they change from organic structure to mechanistic structure. Fine? Now, strategy. Let's learn about strategy. Okay, strategy and environment, and then we are going to sum up with the class. What is this? Lakshmi has given one link. What this link is all about, Lakshmi? So Lakshmi is giving one site. Thank you so much, Lakshmi. So for those people who often change products, okay, they can check this site which Lakshmi is giving. Thank you so much for the information, Lakshmi. It's very good to keep yourself updated on such kind of conference. You see, we just cannot go for anything. See, we are educated people, educated people, so we just cannot go for anything. And certain creams have got certain chemicals which a pregnant woman cannot use, and if she is likely to use that, they can cause fetal abnormalities. Do you know that? And nowadays, many people suffer from skin cancers and all owing to the products, these products and all. ओके ओके थैंक यू सो मच लक्ष्मी, दिस इज अ वेरी गुड इन्फॉर्मेशन यू नो। वाओ थैंक यू सो मच, दैट्स लाइक बीइंग सो विटी एंड काइंड। ओके हाउ एन ऑर्गेनाइजेशन इज गोइंग टू पोजिशन इटसेल्फ इन द मार्केट इन टर्म्स ऑफ इट्स प्रोडक्ट प्रोडक्ट इज कंसिडर्ड इट्स स्ट्रैटेजी। ओके या इवन आई चेक फॉर रिव्यूज। ओके अ कंपनी में डिसाइड टू बी ऑलवेज द फर्स्ट ऑन द मार्केट विद द न्यूएस्ट एंड बेस्ट प्रोडक्ट डिफरेंशिएशन स्ट्रैटेजी, दे ट्राई टू कम अप विद समथिंग डिफरेंट सो दैट द पीपल कैन बाय इट, दे प्रॉमिस समथिंग एल्स व्हिच अदर्स आर नॉट प्रॉमिसिंग, राइट, दिस इज हाउ दे ट्राई टू बिल्ड अप द मार्केट। और इट मे डिसाइड दैट इट विल प्रोड्यूस अ प्रोडक्ट ऑलरेडी ऑन द मार्केट मोर एफिशिएंटली एंड मोर कॉस्ट इफेक्टिवली, कॉस्ट लीडरशिप स्ट्रैटेजी। Each of these strategies require a structure that helps the organization reach its objective. In other words, the structure must fit the strategy. Okay? Companies that want to be the first on the market with the newest and best products probably are organic. Okay? Because organic structures permit organizations to respond quickly to changes. Companies that elect to produce the same product more efficiently and effectively will probably be mechanistic. Fine? Is it clear? Tejo M. Thomas, are you there? You have joined very late. What is the reason? Tejo, please respond in the chat box. Yeah, hi. You've joined very late. What is the reason? Class is going to end in 3 minutes and yeah, I don't know why you're trying to do it. It's okay. So just try to be on time. That's the request. That's it. Okay. It's not like I'm embarrassing you by speaking like this. It's not like that. That's not my motive. Just try to be regular and be on time. Fine? Now, the environment is the world in which organization operates and includes conditions that influences the organization such as economic, social, cultural, legal, political, technological and natural environment conditions. Environments are often described as stable or dynamic. Fine? Clear? In a stable environment, the customer's desires are well understood and probably will remain consistent for a relatively long time. Examples of organizations that face relatively stable environments include manufacturer of staple items such as detergent, cleaning supplies and paper products. Fine. In a dynamic environment, the customer desires are continuously changing, the opposite of stable environment. This condition is often thought as turbulent. In addition, the technology that a company uses while in this environment may need to be continuously improved and updated. An example of an industry functioning in a dynamic environment is electronics. Every day they come up with a new phone. It will have a new operating system, this, that, right? Technology changes create competitive pressures for all electronic industries because as technology changes, so do the desires of consumers. Is it clear? What is the difference between stable environment and organizations functioning in that stable environment and the other one, dynamic environment as well? So we are done for today. We are going to continue with this. And in my next class, that is tomorrow, we'll deal with business English. Okay? Okay, so thank you so much. And you can fill the feedback forms too. So see you tomorrow. Please be there. Thank you so much.